Welcome to Understand the Math. In the video description, you'll find a link to guided notes that can be downloaded and filled in as you follow along with the video. In this video, I'm going to explain what it means to solve a right triangle, present steps to follow for solving a right triangle, and then work through some example problems for solving a right triangle when one side length and one angle are given, and then when two side lengths are given. When you're asked to solve a right triangle, you need to find the unknown sides and the unknown angles. In this picture of a right triangle, we would need to find the unknown sides A, B, and C, and then the unknown angles, alpha and beta. There are two common right triangles that we're often asked to solve. The first one is a right triangle where we're given one side length and the measure of one angle. To find the unknown angle, we would use the fact that alpha plus beta plus our right angle 90 degrees is 180 degrees. And to find the unknown sides, we would use trigonometric ratios. One trigonometric ratio that we could use is that sine theta is equal to the opposite length divided by the length of the hypotenuse. The second common triangle that we're asked to solve is one where we're given two side lengths. To find the unknown side, we would use the Pythagorean theorem and use the fact that one side squared, a squared, plus another side squared is equal to the hypotenuse squared. To find the unknown angles, we would use trigonometric ratios. We'll now look at two examples, one for each case that we just talked about. For this first example, we're asked to solve a triangle where we're given one side length and one angle. Let's go ahead and highlight those. So we're given a hypotenuse of 13 and an angle of 60 degrees. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to label the unknown sides and angles. So we'll label our right-hand side as A, our bottom side as B, and we'll label the angle opposite the side A, alpha. The next thing we'll do is we'll find the unknown angle, and this is alpha. So to find alpha, we're going to use the fact that all three angles have to add up to 180 degrees. So we have alpha plus 60 degrees, plus our right angle, which is 90 degrees, is equal to 180 degrees. So we have alpha plus 150 degrees is 180 degrees. So that tells us that alpha is 180 degrees minus 150 degrees, which is 30 degrees. We'll now find the unknown sides, and those sides are A and B. To find these sides, we're going to use trigonometric ratios. So the ones that we can choose from is we could say that sine theta is opposite over hypotenuse. And we could use cosine theta is adjacent over hypotenuse. We shouldn't use tangent because tangent is opposite over adjacent, and both of those are unknown. So let's begin, and we could use either 30 degrees or 60 degrees. I'm going to use the fact that alpha is 30 degrees, so let's go ahead and let's add that into our diagram. To find side A, we would say that sine of 30 degrees is the opposite, which is A, over the hypotenuse, which is 13. So if we multiply both sides by 13, we see that A is 13 sine 30 degrees. And sine of 30 degrees is one of our special angles. I have a video on that if you'd like to see how we come up with the value for sine 30 degrees. But the value for sine of 30 degrees is 1/2. So this gives us 13 over 2. And let's go ahead and let's add that up into our diagram. So A is 13 over 2. Then we need to find B. Let's go ahead and let's stick with using 30 degrees. So now we would say that cosine 30 degrees is the adjacent, which is B, over the hypotenuse. So if we multiply both sides of the equation by 13, we get B is 13 cosine 30 degrees. So this is 13, and cosine 30 degrees is root 3 over 2. So we're left with 13 root 3 over 2. And we can add that to our diagram. So we have now solved our triangle because we have all the unknown sides and we have all the angles. For our second example, we're asked to solve a right triangle where we're given two side lengths. The first thing we'll do is we'll label the unknown sides and angles. So let's label the bottom side as B, and we'll label the angle opposite B as beta, and then the other angle we'll label alpha. So we'll start by finding the unknown side. You always want to start with finding the one quantity that you don't know. So in this problem, we don't know two angles and we don't know one side. So we start with the side because we only have to find one of them. So to find the side, we're going to use the Pythagorean theorem that says that one side squared plus the other side squared is the hypotenuse squared. So our A is 7, so we have 7 squared plus B squared is our hypotenuse, 25 squared. So this gives us 49 plus B squared is 625. So B squared is 625 minus 49, which is 576. And that's actually a nice number because the square root of 576 is equal to 24. So let's go ahead and let's add that to our picture. We now have to flip the page. So what I did is I went ahead and put the picture up again on the top. So let's go ahead and let's label this the way we had labeled it on the previous page. So we have an alpha, beta, and we just found B is equal to 24. Now what we have to do is find the unknown angles. And to do that, we're going to find them by using trigonometric ratios. So there's a lot of ratios that we can pick from. We could say sine theta is opposite over hypotenuse. Cosine theta is adjacent over hypotenuse, or we could use tangent theta is the opposite over the adjacent. Any of these would work. I'm going to choose to use tangent theta just because I really like using tangent theta. Let's find alpha first. So we would say that tangent alpha, we'll put an alpha here so we know that that's what we're solving for. So tangent alpha is opposite, which is 7, over adjacent, which is 24. So alpha is inverse tan 7 over 24. And that is equal to 16.26 degrees. I would put that in our diagram, but it probably won't fit. So we'll just leave it like that. Now we go to find beta, and we can use tangent again. So we would say tangent beta is opposite, which is our 24, divided by our adjacent, which is 7. So beta is inverse tangent 24 over 7, which when you put it into your calculator, you get 73.74 degrees. One nice built-in check is you can add alpha and beta, and they have to add up to 90 degrees. And if we look at our answers, we can see that it does indeed add up to 90 degrees. Before we end the video, I want to show you an alternate way that we could have calculated beta, which I really think is probably a little bit easier. So after we found alpha, we could have jumped down here and said, well, we know that alpha plus beta plus our right angle 90 degrees is 180 degrees. So we could have plugged in for alpha, so 16.26 degrees plus beta plus 90 degrees is 180 degrees. So beta plus 106.26 degrees, adding 90 and 16, is 180 degrees. And then we could just subtract, and 180 degrees minus 106.26 degrees gives us our 73.74 degrees. So whichever way you're comfortable with is the way that I would stick to find your second angle.
If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day. Thank you.